Hi, this is Rob Teft from the Harris Products Group, and today I want to talk to you about genuine Harris cutting tips versus non-genuine imitation tips. As you can see in the two tips below, on your left is an imitation tip and on your right is a Harris genuine tip. We're going to go through all the details on how you can identify genuine from imitation, and we're going to do a cutting demonstration to show the features and benefits and performance of genuine Harris Products Group cutting tips. It's pretty easy visually to see the difference between genuine Harris on your right and the imitation on your left. If you look at the cone or the exterior piece that's chrome plated, you can see that when the tip is set upright like this, the writing is the correct direction. If you look at the imitation, your writing will be upside down. Also, on the genuine Harris, you're gonna have the Harris round logo, and it will say made by Harris on that cone. Another very easy way to identify is if you take apart the two-piece tip, the insert on the inside is also going to identify the model number of the tip and the size. So if you have multiple tips in your shop or on your work site and your inserts get separated from the cones, you're able to easily identify which insert goes inside which cone on genuine Harris. The imitation tips will not have that identification. I'd like to talk about the brass that we use to manufacture in genuine Harris tips. We always use the highest quality brass bar stock available on the market. If you look at the two tips, to the right is genuine Harris, and you can tell it's just visibly much brighter and shinier because of that higher quality metal. To the left, you can see a duller brass appearance, and that's just due to the lower quality brass used. And not only is that gonna be a visual indication of genuine Harris versus imitation, but it's also gonna lead to much better performance in the field. It's gonna take a lot more heat in your cutting applications, and it's gonna have a much longer life than imitation products. Now I'd like to talk about the base or the seat of the tips. As you can see here, the genuine Harris is a darker brass, a higher quality brass. Also, there's two sets of holes. One is the single hole in the center of the tip, which is the cutting oxygen hole. As you can see, it's a clean, precise cut for Harris. The imitation has a bevel edge. And then the exterior holes, which are the preheat holes, you can see Harris has a very even concentric hole pattern when the imitation is not even, and it will not give you that consistent, clean preheat that we're looking for. The seat or the base of the tip is very important. If the seat doesn't sit perfectly into the torch, your tip is not going to perform properly because it's going to pull out atmospheric air into the cutting stream. And every 1% of atmospheric air compared to pure oxygen will decrease your cutting capability by 25%. So it's going to cost much more money to operate the same tip if you don't have the proper seat in that tip. Harris Genuine tips will always have that proper seat. With genuine Harris, you can see that that internal cone is very bright and very concentric and very even. So when you're preheating the plate and cutting, you need to have that concentric, even inner cone to help best preheat the plate and cut the plate. I want to talk about the competitive imitation tips cone consistencies. So you can see in these pictures close up and in the video that the imitation tips are not as consistent because of the low quality brass and the imprecise machining. From a visual perspective, you can tell a difference, but from a performance perspective is where you're gonna feel the difference. It's gonna take longer to preheat, you're gonna need more oxygen and more fuel to get the steel up to temperature to cut, and it's gonna slow down production overall. As you can see from the flames and the pictures that we added to this video, the Harris tip is going to be much more consistent. And while that may not matter to some of the operators, it should matter to the businesses buying these tips, because the less consistent, the longer it's going to take to preheat your metal and cut your metal, which is going to increase the cost. So if you can get a tighter, more consistent inner cone, you'll get a better cut faster, which will reduce your overall costs.